gangsta shit on the nigga. Lil Baby, what part?
I can't be toting no handguns unless that bitch come with a thuddy. I can't be fucking these dog hoes unless that bitch come with a buddy.
With a friend.
I can't be driving no regular cars. That bitch gotta come with a button. I was broke like a wild bat. Now I'm up all of a sudden.
Now I'm up there.
I can't be rapping for free. They gotta send me the budget.
Send me that.
I can't be fucking these hoes off. I had to slip on the rubber.
Give me that.
I can't be rocking no plain Jane. Both of my watches be flooded. I can't be drinking no regular soda. All of my cups be muddy. I just came home with nothing. Now I'm up all of a sudden.
Hey, now I'm up all of a sudden. Hey,
now I'm up all of a sudden.
Hey, hey.
Yeah, man. It's your boy Hood Legend right here.
You already know your boy Ace.
Yeah, right here about to recap that Nome 8 that just happened in Houston and shit. You know what I'm saying? Smacking the boys. You know what I'm saying? Then took the URL movement on a tour. First they was in Florida. Then they came to Raleigh. Now they're in Houston. You know what I'm saying? So I'm kind of feeling what they doing with the URL movement, taking it on the road and shit. So we actually went to BLS 2 in Raleigh. You know what I'm saying? That shit was hot as a motherfucker.
Yo, that shit was fucking like, woo! Shit was the fire department code, like, past that shit. Like, it was hot. AC went out. Goddamn niggas. It was like 100 niggas in there. Maybe 5 females in that bit. That bit was hot. It was hot up in there. Like, for real. But it was all right. It was a good turnout, though. Niggas was respecting what was going on. Niggas was still staying in there, watching all the battles. So, shout out to basically everybody in Raleigh. I know niggas came from Charlotte, wherever, surrounding areas. But shout out to everybody who came out to the BLS, too, because we was in the building. It was good in there, though. A lot of niggas came out. It was a good turnout for Raleigh. You know what I'm saying? So, shout out to the niggas, yo.
Yeah, shout out. Fire event, anyway. But back to Nome 8. You know what I'm saying? We gonna recap this shit. Smack started off. They started off with like a PG battle, LOSO PG, LOSO versus SCOTTY. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? SCOTTY was at home. It was like a home game for SCOTTY, so it was a pretty good battle to start off the night. I got LOSO winning the battle. You know, the sum of all love. I got LOSO winning the battle.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's just my preference. I got LOSO with the first and the third. SCOTTY took the second. He had some crazy balls. LOSO first, he had some shit where he said, we can get it shaking with the hands. You want the Scott Hall or the Scott Steiner?
Yeah, I remember that part.
I felt that shit.
That was nice. I mean, LOSO had in the first round, not even gonna lie, he was real consistent. He kept up with his poise. His performance, like, LOSO, I've never seen LOSO not have a problem with performance. So, and I like LOSO. LOSO's, even though what he rap about is still relevant, because he make it relevant to what's going on. So LOSO has always been like a battler that came consistent, came with work. Like, he always be prepared. So I like this first round. His second round, he was kind of shaky. But his third round, yeah, he cleaned up his mess in his third round. SCOTTY, I like SCOTTY first round. I did not like SCOTTY second round. I'm not even gonna lie. I did not like SCOTTY second.
He won the second, though.
I did not like his second round.
I feel like he won the second. Even though LOSO had the infamous Mike Jones line, that nigga said that something. He spelled the Mike Jones number out in the crowd.
Oh, yeah. I know what you're talking about.
Went bananas for that shit. So I give LOSO credit for that penmanship on that particular line.
Right.
Because he critique that just for the crowd in Houston. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
And so I give him credit for that line. But anyway, it was a good battle. I give it to LOSO 2-1. What's your prediction on that battle?
I give LOSO, it's 2-1. I give it to LOSO 2-1. I felt like if SCOTTY would have came a little bit harder. I like SCOTTY third round. I feel like he could have changed things in second. His second round, I didn't like.
When you get SCOTTY, you ain't like his second round.
I didn't like his second round.
Okay, well, you like his first, but you can give him the first and the third.
I can't give him the third because LOSO came to work in his third. I can't give SCOTTY the third because LOSO came to work. I ain't going to say SCOTTY didn't come to work in his third, but SCOTTY third was not. His energy level wasn't as high, or his performance level wasn't as high as LOSO was in his third. Because you could tell LOSO was coming, like, he was speaking straight from the heart. You know what I'm saying? Like, his energy level kicked up a little bit.
He's the best Christian battle rapper in the game right now as far as battle rap. He done surpassed the Saga. The Saga had the crown for a minute, but now LOSO, like, it seemed like he's on every card. like niggas want him on like the car as far as RBE when he first got a chance with RBE.
Yeah.
After that, that niggas he like niggas been wanting him on every car. KOTD, they wanted him on the car.
Yeah.
So he's been battling.
Yeah.
But I gave him the first and the third.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what's up.
Then second battle.
Second battle was
DNA and JC.
Okay. Now that one, I can't give you my full prediction in because that one is that's a funny one to watch, and I only watched bits and pieces of it. I didn't get the chance to watch the entire battle with JC and DNA. But I know JC from what I seen. The round that I seen from JC and the round I seen from DNA, them niggas was putting in work.
Yeah.
Especially, yeah. It was the second round that I watched. JC's yeah. second round, JC's second round was funny.
The first round is debatable. I feel like the first round is debatable. It's mm-hmm. all on preference. Okay. Who you feel like won that first round? The first round was preference, basically, because both of them was fire. DNA came out firing.
Mm-hmm.
JC came out firing, so... Mm-hmm. I feel like the first round is just debatable. It's up in the air.
Okay.
I can't call it.
Okay.
But the second round, DNA brung out Tech N9ne.
Yeah.
And part of his round.
That's what made me give it. That's what kind of wanted to make me give it to DNA. But then JC was putting in work.
Yeah, but I kind of liked that he brung out Tech N9ne, but then again, I didn't like it because it seemed like DNA done did some shit like that before where he... always fuck with the crowd. Give me a word, and he freestyle and shit like that. So
yeah.
It's like he brung Tech N9ne from Champion out,
mm-hmm.
talk like basically commentating and asking him questions, which it was cool. But I really won't kind of like feeling that shit. He should have. If anything, I would have brung K-Shine out. Why'd you bringing out Tech N9ne?
Fact.
I would have brung out K-Shine.
You battled Tech N9ne and whooped his ass.
I don't know. Yeah.
To me, when I saw the battle between him and Tech N9ne, they battled. Yeah, DNA. DNA took that. Tech N9ne took that L straight up. I'm sorry, Tech N9ne took that L. DNA came to work that night. They battled each other, and I remember that shit. That was on one of the. That was on the one of the new little battles that when it was first starting out, DNA was just now getting big. I think it was after his first Summer Madness, or it was just before his first Summer Madness.
I'm not for sure on that. I'm not for sure on that, but like I said, that angle was okay.
Yeah.
But like I said, it feel like something he already did before.
Yeah.
You know, but you know, the second round, I still edged it to DNA. I edged DNA the second round.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Then it basically comes down to the third, and then the third, I gave it to JC. I feel like JC had more metaphors, like more angles. He was coming at DNA more than DNA was coming at him. He had more like personals, if you want to say.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like the battle, in my opinion, would go to JC.
Okay.
But
okay, that's what's up. I mean, hey,
other people may think different. I don't. You know what I'm saying?
I hope niggas do think different. That's what that's what make it good.
That's simply my opinion. No, I don't know.
Yeah. Okay. So third battle. The third battle was... Damn, who was the third battle?
TAY-ROC and GOODZ.
Ha! Woo! My nigga. Hey, look. First thing first, I did not think that was going to be as good as a battle as it was.
Battle of the night.
You think so?
Battle of the night.
Cause niggas was saying Rum Nitty and Surf was battle of the night. And I ain't so I'm just gonna
Surf choked in this third round. How could it be battle of the night?
But you know, people not gonna speak up. But we get to that later.
Alright.
So but GOODZ TAY-ROC. That to me was GOODZ showed up. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah.
Because him versus A Verb, I ain't seen him show up. Him versus A Verb.
Him versus Jims.
Yeah,
that was his last battle, him versus Jims, when that fight happened and broke out and shit.
But I mean that. But I was looking at terms of his wordplay and stuff like that. He came to perform sometimes. Like his first round versus A Verb, he came to work. But His gym's battle, no, he did not. He didn't show up at all.
Yeah, he didn't give a fuck.
Like, he didn't show up at all.
It's like that battle, he just wanted to check.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He was already probably locked in for TAY-ROC, so he just wanted to check. Like, mm-hmm. Yo, fuck it, I'm going to get this little bag real quick. Mm-hmm. But anyway, the first round, GOODZ came out swinging.
Oh,
that
yes.
Nigga came yes. out swinging. He went first. TAY-ROC won the coin toss. GOODZ go first. So GOODZ come out. That nigga is... He's swagging on him. He got the double cup. He in Houston. He got the two styrofoam cups.
He feeling good.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, this nigga really is just, like, going ham.
Facts.
He had the orthopedic sneaker line. That nigga had, he said, what do a hustler do when you put rock in front of him? He said, you cook him. This nigga went crazy. Like, his first round was crazy.
Bruh, GOODZ first round.
shit on the nigga. Lil Bay Hood Park.
I can't be toting no handguns unless the bitch come with a thuddy. I can't be fucking these dog hoes unless the bitch come with a buddy.
With a friend.
I can't be driving no regular cars. The bitch gotta come with a button. I was broke like a wild bat. Now I'm up all of a sudden.
Now I'm up there.
I can't be rapping for free. They gotta send.